Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of Health 360. This week we're going to be telling you all about the health and wellness stories that have been trending in India and outside. First of all, let's begin by telling you all about pigeon poop. Well, you heard that right. I'm going to be telling you all about pigeon poop. But why on a health show? You'll find out later. And how have tattoos now been linked to cancer? That and much more up ahead on the show. I'm Sneha Moldani. The harmless looking pigeon is not so harmless anymore. My colleague Lavanya in this report is telling you why pigeons are a cause of health concern in major urban Indian metropolitan cities. Why so? Why has pigeon poop been linked to increase in lung disease? Why are children particularly vulnerable? And what are the precautions to be taken? Here's more.
Pigeons are considered a symbol of love, peace, freedom and harmony. We've seen how Bollywood has often used them as a prop to enhance its scenes and emotions. Pigeons had been used as messengers in the past, but they've lost their charm lately. But why do you think we are telling you about pigeons? And why pigeons on a health show? Pigeon droppings are causing huge health concerns, and that is the precise reason why.
Pigeons have become cause of concern because the pigeon population is increasing day by day. And second important thing, a disease called hypersensitivity pneumonia, which is also increasing. Pigeons are concerned because one important reason for hypersensitivity pneumonia is exposure to birds. Okay, and birds droppings, birds feather antigens and various other antigens which comes from the birds are responsible for giving a condition called hypersensitivity pneumonia.
Pigeon droppings look like small marbles and have a white brownish appearance, and it is when these droppings dry out and turn into dust that they become airborne and can be inhaled and cause diseases like cryptococcosis, histoplasmosis and cytokosis.
These are lung disease which is called fibrotic lung disease. It so happens that lung gradually become fibrosed and it gets scarred. It is known as hypersensitivity pneumonitis. It is not an infection. It is rather a chronic disease which is slowly progressive. And if the exposure is continuing over a period of time, it becomes irreversible and eventually the only treatment might as well be lung transplant.
People are indeed being infected by it. And it's a major concern. Listen in to those who have suffered.
मुझे चलने में बहुत तकलीफ होती थी. 5 मिनट भी चलता था तो कहाँ पे बैठ के थोड़ा आराम कर लेता था. फिर चलता था. और सांस लेने में बहुत तकलीफ होती थी. मेरा घर 3 मंजिल पे है. तो वहाँ पे अपना सीढ़ी से चढ़ पाना भी मुश्किल हो रहा था. जो पहले मैं दौड़ के चढ़ जाता था. मुझे ये बीमारी के बारे में कुछ पता नहीं था. फाइब्रोसिस ILD जिसको हाइपरसेंसिटिविटी न्यूमेटिटिक बोलते हैं. ये कबूतर का एक्सक्रेशन से होता है और मुझे ये सब पता नहीं था. तो विंडो के ऊपर बैठ के मैं पोते के साथ में घंटों भर बैठा रहता था. जहाँ पिजन्स कबूतर आजू बाजू में रहते थे लेकिन मुझे कुछ ये पता नहीं था बीमारी के बारे में. तो हम लोग घंटों भर बैठते थे. अक्टूबर 22 में सांस लेने की तकलीफ हुई तो मैं काफ़ी डॉक्टर्स के पास गया तो किसी ने बोला अस्थमा है क्या है. फिर मुझे बोला गया कि आप सीटी स्कैन निकालो. सीटी स्कैन निकाला तो उसमें से पता चला कि ये हाइपरसेंसिटिविटी इसके लिए है. फाइब्रोसिस है. तो मैंने सब इलाज चालू किया.
इट डजंट एंड हियर. आफ्टर ट्रीटमेंट इट टेक्स टाइम फॉर द पेशेंट टू गेट बैक टू देयर डेली रूटीन.
मेरी दवाइयाँ सब चालू है अक्टूबर 22 से. रिहैब सेंटर है जहाँ पे मैं आता हूँ रेगुलरली थ्राइस इन अ वीक. जो ट्रेडमिल और ये सब अंडर डॉक्टर्स ऑब्जर्वेशन फिजियोथेरापिस्ट कराते हैं ऑक्सीजन थेरापी देते हैं और उसके लिए मेरी कंडीशन काफ़ी स्टेबल है।
Feeding pigeons is a very common practice across India, especially in metro cities. From appeasing celestial bodies to just for fun, metro dwellers love feeding pigeons. But this fun can lead us to trouble, as feeding them is not only hazardous for the birds, since it weakens their hunting instincts, but it can also cause serious diseases in humans.
This pigeons feeding, you know, it's considered as a some religious thing, which also is concerned, because a lot of people which are on this reason, religious reason, they go and feed the pigeons. Whenever there are hundreds of pigeons accumulated at one place, it's not the person who is actually feeding is gets the disease, but the antigens are there in the environment, because this is an airborne, and people who are working or just staying there, or also who are vegetable vendors, etc., who are standing besides that, okay, they also get a high exposure of these antigens through environment, and they get the disease into the lung.
Sandhya Joshi resides near a kabutar khana, which led her to be infected with the disease because of pigeons. She had symptoms like cough, shortness of breath and fatigue.
मैं एक साल से मुझे थकान लग रही थी और चलने में चलते टाइम बहुत दम लग रहा था। मुझे लगा कुछ हार्ट का है, इसलिए मैं मेरे हार्ट के डॉक्टर के पास गई। उन्होंने देखा तो खांसी की वजह से उन्होंने मुझे चेक्स एक्सरे निकालने के लिए बोला, और बाकी सब हम बाद में करेंगे बोले। तो चेक्स एक्सरे निकाला तो उन्होंने उनको कुछ लगा, तो इसीलिए उन्होंने सीटी स्कैन और टूडी एको बोला। तो टूडी एको में तो अच्छा सब आ गया, और सीटी स्कैन में थोड़े पैचेस आ गए और उनको कुछ दिखा, और उसमें फाइब्रोसिस लिखा था। मैंने जब भी टेस्ट किया तो वहाँ पॉजिटिव आ गया पिजन ड्रॉपिंग। जब भी ये हो गया तभी मैंने डॉक्टर से पूछा कि ये क्यों हुआ, कैसे हुआ, तो उन्होंने पिजन ड्रॉपिंग के वजह से ही हुआ है बोला। और हमारे खिड़की में बहुत आते थे कबूतर, तो उनके पिजन ड्रॉपिंग तो होता था, हमारे खिड़की में तो बहुत आते थे। बाद में थोड़ा थोड़ा कम हो गया था, लेकिन उसके वजह से ही ये शायद हो गया होगा।
It's critical to take care and avoid prolonged exposure to significant amounts of pigeon droppings, especially in enclosed or poorly ventilated spaces. When cleaning pigeon droppings, it's best to wear disposable gloves, shoe covers and masks with filters that can trap particles as fine as 0.3 micron.
So if you got a building where you live and in a society, so as a society level we should work to prevent that pigeon should not get into your building. So that is the most important one. If it that is there, at least clean your room, at least vacuum cleaning should be there, and the dropping should be avoided. And while cleaning the dropping, whosoever is cleaning should be precautious.
Pigeon feathers, dust and droppings can become airborne when cleaned or disturbed, potentially exposing people to respiratory irritants. Pigeon population management is critical not only for minimizing the spread of droplet-borne diseases, but also for lowering the likelihood of ectoparasite infestations. There are widespread efforts to prohibit feeding pigeons in public locations, but awareness levels are poor. Bureau Report, India Today.
A quick check of what's making news in the health sector in our health wrap.
The Chandipura virus has claimed the lives of 8 children in the Aravali district of Gujarat. Chandipura vesiculovirus causes high fever and severe headaches. The virus primarily affects children and has been associated with outbreaks of acute encephalitis in India. Due to the lack of specific antiviral treatments, early diagnosis and supportive care are critical. Lung cancer is affecting Indians who have never smoked in their life, which in fact is the major cause of lung cancer in the West. The primary culprit remains air pollution in India, especially in urban areas. Chronic exposure to microscopic pollutants like PM2.5 can trigger mutations in lung cells, eventually leading to cancer. The risk is significant even for non-smokers who breathe polluted air daily. Dementia has been constantly rising worldwide. Dementia majorly causes memory loss and inability to make decisions. Early signs of dementia include insomnia, frequent nighttime awakenings, restless leg syndrome, interrupted breathing during sleep, REM sleep behavior disorders, daytime sleepiness, vivid dreams, and circadian rhythm disruptions. Detecting dementia is important for its effective management and in some cases preventing its progression. India recorded 1.6 million zero-dose children in 2023, leaving behind countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan. Zero-dose children, who defined by WHO, are those who lack access to or are never reached by routine immunization services. India ranks among the 10 worst countries in mass immunization, which is more than just concerning. Weight loss drug tirzepatide could be introduced in India soon. The drug has been crucial in controlling obesity cases in the US and Europe. The pending clearances are likely to be granted soon.
It's time for a quick commercial break here. Much more news on the other side.